target is Angola's Mfinda oil field, upstream from the landing point. A spill has covered the whole area in crude. A pipeline that crosses the Muneni River failed, and now the shore's a mess. Not to mention the villages downstream have no drinking water. The oil runs to the pipeline from that facility. Taking it out should end the leak. The client this time is an environmental NGO. Destroy the facility. Stop that leak. This may seem like straight-up philanthropy, but there's another reason we agreed to it. The Mfinda oil field was outdated, abandoned. Then the rebel group UNITA moved in, taking it upon themselves to kickstart operations. UNITA's been rapidly modernizing its arsenal. Rumor has it someone's been selling them U.S. military hardware. Intel's analysis suggests the broker's a front company, Cipher's. Keeping tabs on UNITA could tell us who's pulling its strings.
She demonstrated her marksmanship against that enemy fighter plane. It showed she was much more than your everyday crack shot. Hitting a moving target from 600 meters is a challenge, but it's possible.
The war industry we started has taken a pretty crooked course these past 9 years. With no other options, soldiers have become dogs of war, sent to conflict zones as private forces, or PFs. Guys we fought alongside are dying all around the globe for no reason, no banner. But it's how they survive. The demand for PFs here in Africa is especially high. Cold War standoffs, resource exploitation, tribal clashes. What's big business for developed countries has only brought conflict here. That mess you're standing in is just the latest example.
The chopper and the missile were in motion, meaning different vectors at high velocity in three-dimensional space, and...
You've arrived at Masa Village. It's been turned into a supply hub for UNITA, meaning it'll be stocked with weapons and resources. Should be a thing or two that'll come in handy. Don't be shy. They deserve to be in better hands.
You put her in a fighter jet, and she'd be an ace right off the bat.
Now, children. Child soldiers. Children there are abducted and trained to be soldiers. They're only taught to fight. Then one day they grow up and teach the next generation the same way. With a gun in his hands, a kid is as dangerous as any adult. Only they don't know a thing about right and wrong. Boss, do not hurt any child soldiers. If you do, the mission is over.
Quiet is still in her cell. Only a few staff are authorized to go near her. She hasn't tried anything funny, but that's what bothers me most.
In particular?
What does she have to gain by coming to Mother Base? I first thought she was under orders from Cipher to take you out. She didn't manage it in Afghanistan, so round two happens here. So I lighten the guard. And that lock on her door is a joke.
You gave her an opening. And?
Well, she hasn't killed you yet. And I hate to say it, but she's had plenty of chances.
You made me the bait.
Poisonous bait. What better? Anyway, she didn't bite. Quiet is keeping her silence. So I'm left with no idea again what she's doing.
The PF soldiers are speaking Afrikaans, an official language of the Republic of South Africa. Boss, we're gonna need someone with the Afrikaans interpreter skill to understand what they're saying. We'll look into it here, but for now, you'll just have to make do without one.
It'd be picked up by our counterintelligence net, but it's clean. There's no sign she's had contact with the staff, the base facilities, nothing. She's almost got the men wanting her to try something, just to find out what she's up to. And she's in there putting on the failed soldier look, all downcast eyes and defeated sighs. But she doesn't kill herself. She can't be trying to leave Cipher and surrender to us.
So what's the verdict?
This may sound optimistic, but here's how I see it. Quiet came here to fulfill some objective. To kill you, maybe to destroy Diamond Dogs. Whatever it was, before she could do it, something changed her mind. Yes. When I look at her, I sense hesitation.
He's coming too. Roger that.
Can't say for sure. I prefer the ones that talk. Anyway, we'll keep her under watch. And we're also looking into those special abilities of hers. You'll be the first to know if something comes up. Why not look in on her yourself once in a while?
Right.
You gotta extract him.
It wasn't just Cipher. Back in the Caribbean, every eye in the world was turned on us. A private army. Just a bunch of guys with guns in possession of a nuke? Why wouldn't they be uncomfortable?
And that's why you made sure the inspection happened.
Well, I thought our best move was to prove to the UN through the IAEA that we had no nuke. Of course, I was against us having it in the first place, but that was Snake's decision.
The boss wasn't responsible.
Well, don't get me wrong. I still believed in Snake. I thought I was making the best decision for all of us, that's all. I figured we should get a third party to exonerate us before proof of the nuke did get out. And who better to do that than an organization with international authority?
So the truth is, you took it upon yourself to agree to an inspection arranged by the UN. Only the inspection was a ruse, and Cipher Strike Force XOF showed up instead.
I had no idea that would happen.
Enough bullshit.
Oh, sure, like I could have known. You know, I was just trying to prove our innocence to the world. What's wrong with that?
We're not interested in the excuses you've thought up. The truth is objective.
Just see it from my point of view.
You led XOF to the control tower. They seized it, giving them complete control over the base. Moments later, they detonated C4
on... Subject on board. Leave the rest to us.
...managed to survive was hunted down by the assault force and their choppers.
You can't believe I did that on purpose!
That was the end of Mother Base. But it wasn't the end for you.
How can you... Look, think about it. I lost something too. I built Zeke and it got buried underwater. I am a victim!
That raises the big questions. Why were you the only one spared? You got away without a scratch. Why did Strangelove leave the base on the eve of the inspection? You two were close.
Strangelove?
And how did you manage to build something that surpasses Zeke in every way? Because you did everything they told you. You're the only one who didn't lose a thing.
Rain. Sound of rainfall should help to mask your footsteps.
Away against my will. Skullface forced me to do his research these past 9 years. He used me. I lost 9 years.
9 years. We all lost 9 years. It wasn't just you.
I suppose blaming me makes you feel better, does it? But who is gonna give me back all the time I lost?
You're not getting anything back.
You're not a victim here, Emmerich. You're the perpetrator.
I didn't know anything.
Nobody can back that up.
Yeah. All the evidence is at the bottom of the ocean.
You know the hardest man to break. The type who's fooling himself. That takes time. It's easier to live a convenient lie than a painful truth. Is that the peace you've chosen, Doc?
I'm not lying.
Of course. Just let me check one or two things. On that day, you were in the control tower with him. Lucky you. That's how you got out unscathed.
He's coming too. Roger that.
One of their choppers, only you, right before the base went under.
They had me blindfolded the whole time. I've never been so scared. The whole flight, I thought they'd kill me. But thinking of you kept me going. My comrades, all the way.
And?
There was a plane journey, and then we traveled by road. When they finally took off the blindfold, I was in kind of a warehouse, on the floor. Afghanistan, it was that research lab. I couldn't believe they'd taken me halfway around the world. And soon enough, he came.
Skullface.
He's the one who's really behind that mother base attack. He forced me into that research.
What kind of research?
He told me to build a bipedal walking tank for the Soviet Union. Like Peace Walker. A system that could fire an ICBM-class nuclear weapon. That's how the Sahelanthropus project got started.
Sahelanthropus.
Those AI weapons I'd made in Costa Rica were like toys by comparison. A whole world apart from reptilian four-legged crawling and that ridiculous hunched-over bipedal waddling.
Subject on board. Leave the rest to us. You've made it past the village. Continue heading for the oil facility. It's located upriver.
An upright bipedal weapon system. Originally, Sahelanthropus was going to be a manned weapons platform. I designed a cockpit in its head, and I planned to...
Within the oil field is the property of Saner, South African Natural Resources. Saner drills oil wells wherever they can throughout that region. And when the oil dries up, they abandon the facility. Then it's only a matter of time before the aging equipment starts leaking crude. That means United's takeover is the perfect cover for Saner. Now they can blame the spill on a bunch of oil thieves. However you look at it, Saner's far from squeaky clean.
I got it down to less than a tenth the size without any loss in computation speed. But it was still too big for the...
That used to be a settlement. But now it's burned to the ground.
Head bigger, its body would have to be bigger to support it. Too big to be practical. In the end, human piloting was taken off the table.
There it is. The oil facility. To stop the leak, you need to shut down the oil transfer pump and destroy the oily water separator tank. The details are on your iDroid.
I went back to trying an AI-only system. To do that, I had the AI pods recovered from Nicaragua. This was a hybrid AI, a combination of Peace Walker's reptile and mammal pods, the only AIs that had ever successfully operated an unmanned nuclear weapon system.
Really? You'd need some help to get that working. Expert help.
Did you work with someone?
I worked alone.
You did that yourself?
That's the thing. The AI didn't pan out in the end either. But I did finally get Sahelanthropus walking by folding over its upper body to lower its center of gravity. The first upright bipedal locomotive weapon system in the history. Mind. I guess, technically it falls into the anthropoid ape category.
I don't see the benefit of having it stand taller.
On terrain with significant differences in elevation, like Afghanistan, you need a body that's vertically adaptable. That also lets it attack from long range while using mountain ridges for cover. So, making it walk upright was the most important factor in giving it superior height capability. As the name suggests, that was the whole point of Sahelanthropus. But I was being pushed for results. Having the AI mounted externally would have been the fastest way to get it working. I just needed more data so it could maintain its balance. But Skullface refused to wait. He dismissed the idea of AI control and took Sahelanthropus away from me before I could finish it.
But it was walking when it came after you.
That's just it. I don't understand how Skullface got it to move upright. Without a pilot or an AI. And walking at that speed, too. It's beyond anything I could have imagined. This is like the Wright brothers making it to the moon. I'm just as clueless as you are.
So this Sahelanthropus, where is it now?
I have no idea. All my experiments took place at that cave. I've never seen it anywhere else. Besides...
He's coming too. Roger that.
Nothing but a paper tiger. Even if it can't... can walk, it's far from being a viable weapons platform. It wouldn't be useful in actual battle.
Destroy that separator tank.
Emmerich will remain here at
all right, you planted the C4. Don't set it off until you're at a safe distance.
That work for you? Fine by me. He can't be allowed any contact with staff either.
Yeah. A lot of the guys would love some payback for 9 years ago. We still need him alive. But we have to restrict his movements. He can only go where we tell him. And of course, the interrogations will continue. He worked for that skull bastard for nearly a decade. He still has more to tell us.
How long are we gonna press him?
If our investigation shows he really had nothing to do with the attack, we'll reconsider his place here. But I don't expect that to happen. Remember that water tank-shaped object in Emmerich's lab in the Soviet base camp? The thing that started talking to you like a possessed answering machine. That was a pod belt for housing the AI used to control unmanned weapons. You remember, back in 74 in Costa Rica, it was in those machines you fought there. They were designated Pupa, Chrysalis, Cocoon, and Basilisk. And each of them was fitted with an AI unit called a reptile pod. Emmerich created it. It mainly handled the machine's posture control and autonomous behavior. But the Basilisk, a.k.a. Peace Walker, also featured a second AI pod. That one was called the Mammal Pod. And it was created by Dr. Strange.
Subject on board. Leave the rest to us. Good. You're away from the tank. Once it goes up, the enemy will come running. Secure the area before you detonate the C4.
Just like a human brain compensating for damage by using the remaining healthy parts. The result was a unique entity. A hybrid of the reptile and the mammal. It sank to the bottom of Lake Nicaragua with Peace Walker. But apparently they salvaged it and transported it to that lab. Don't let it deceive you, Snake. It may sound like the boss, but it has neither a personality nor a will. Like Emmerich says, it's just a machine.
Development project has been added.
Ever since the attack on your unit 9 years ago, the name Big Boss has become known the world over.
What do you mean?
Those of your men who survived traveled far and wide. They fought throughout the world. In fact, they're part of the reason we have all these PFs now. Every one of them suffered their own phantom pain from losing you. Talking about you wherever they went helped to heal their wounds. Your actions and words, your legend, has been told on every battlefield they've set foot on. Obviously, as the tales have spread, the truth's been distorted, painted over. Big Boss sacrificed himself to show us the threat that...
He's coming too. Roger that.
Warning, so it goes.
A warning?
Too much power destroys the hands that hold it. Apparently, you chose to be a living example of that.
I never said any of that.
The moment any truth is passed on, it starts turning into fiction. The problem is, fiction inspires people more than facts. To the world, you're now the legendary mercenary Big Boss. The lessons you've taught the PFs are the reason they're so widespread. They're the reason they've survived. And you know what they all aspire to? To one day go nuclear, just like you did. And stand up to Cipher.
Of all the stupid things you could do,
they'll never understand what you really wanted. Heroes are misunderstood. It takes a man of the same caliber to understand what drives them. Bottom line is, these guys want to be like their hero, Big Boss. And deep down, they all have their eyes on nuclear weapons. They say that a nuke is the only means of standing against Cipher. But these days, it's becoming little more than a slogan to rally the troops and survive in a cutthroat business.
Currently, there are three major PFs who've expanded into central...
There's the transfer pump control room. The emergency stop button is probably inside it.
HEC's investigations have shown there's almost no overlap between their areas of operation. It's not so much a turf war, more like they have a gentleman's agreement. If you do cross paths with them, you probably won't have to face more than one at a time. Still, don't expect a walk in the park.
Thank you.
Oil transfer pump shutoff confirmed. Next, destroy the oily water separator tank. That'll ensure they can never use the facility again.
He's coming too. Roger that.
Separator tank. Objectives complete.
Arrived.
Though security will be tighter after that explosion. Get out of there ASAP.
Info has been updated. Extraction, support helicopter,
Roger.
Requested. Please select a mission. Unit dispatched. Unit dispatched.
Facility all the while pretending they were the victims. One other thing. Singer's Johannesburg head office is just a room in a multi-tenant building. Company's essentially non-existent. 3 years ago, that investment fund stepped in and started gutting it through a series of mergers and sell-offs. And get this, the fund itself no longer exists either. It's a shell corporation, meaning someone is just using Singer's name from the shadows. But what about those strange corpses? Just what the hell were they doing over there?
Hey! Snake! I've customized a walker gear just for you. It features a silent running system, great for infiltration missions. And you can also summon it to your location. I've taken the liberty of calling it the D-Walker. It's armed with a suppressed tranquilizer gun. If you want to add other weaponry or upgrade the chassis, give the order from your iDroid.